Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyid al-Anbiya wal Mursaleen. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. فَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ حَامِيم وَالْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ إِنَّا كُنَّا مُنذِرِينَ وَقَالَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this world and everything in it for the benefit of mankind. He created the moon, the sun, the stars, the sky, the earth, the mountains, everything. Similarly, he created various seasons for the benefit of humanity. And on that note, he has also assigned various seasons for a particular ibadah. These special occasions, these various seasons are designated for an increased ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, all the believers are expected to be performing all the ibadat following the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout their lives. Yet these special opportunities exist in order that the believers may get an opportunity, may get a chance to attain the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And among these special occasions is the month of Shaban we are in. Today is the 7th of Shaban. This month is the month in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam particularly used to increase his ibadat, his fasting, his prayers, his recitation of glorious Quran. It alone shows the importance of this month. There is a hadith, and this hadith is recorded by Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih al-Muslim, Abu Dawood, Imam Nasai rahmatullah alayhi has also recorded the same hadith. Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha narrates, she said, قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم حتى نقول لا يفطر ويفطر حتى نقول لا يصوم فما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم استكمل صيام شهر إلا رمضان وما رأيته أكثر صياما منه في شعبان. Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, أم المؤمنين, says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast for so many days till we thought that he would never break his fast. And he used to do iftar for so many days that we thought that he would never fast again. I never saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to complete fast the whole month except the month of Ramadan, and used to fast frequently more than in the month of Shaban. There is another hadith, and this hadith is narrated by Usama bin Zayd radiyallahu ta'ala an, in which he says, قَالَ قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَمْ أَرَكَ أَن تَصُومَ شَهْرًا مِنَ الشُّهُورِ مَا تَصُومُ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ قَالَ ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ بَيْنَ رَجَبٍ وَرَمْضَانِ وهو شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى رب العالمين فأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. Usama bin Zayd radiyallahu ta'ala says that I said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, I never saw you fasting any month more than in the month of Shaban. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is the month many people are ignorant of being between Rajab and Shaban. And this is the month in which the A'mal are raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Rabbul Alameen. Thus, I wish my A'mal, my A'mal is raised when I am fasting. And this hadith is recorded by Abu Dawood and Nasai, and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah also mentioned this hadith in his Musnad. There's also another hadith, and this hadith is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, in which his an Abi Hurayrah radiallahu ta'ala an, he said anna Aisha haddathathum anna Nabiya sallallahu alayhi sallam kana yasumu sha'bana kullahu qalat qultu ya Rasulullah أحب الشهور إليك أن تصومه شعبان قال إن الله يكتب على كل نفس ميتة تلك السنة فأحب أن يأتي أجلي وأنا صائم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. And this hadith is recorded by Abu Ya'la in his Musnad, and also this hadith is found in Targhib and Tarhib. The meaning of this hadith is Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala narrates that Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha narrated this hadith to them that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam fasted the whole month of Sha'ban. She said, I asked Ya Rasulullah, is Sha'ban your most favorite month to fast? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigns the year of death for each person in the month of Sha'ban. Thus, I wish my death comes when I am fasting. This is the hadith recorded by Targhib wa Tarhib with Sahih Isnad. And also Abu Ya'la has given the place to this hadith in his Musnad. So following these hadiths, there are some certain points which I want to bring to your notice. Following this hadith, we come to know that the month of Sha'ban is a month of virtue, is of importance, and Sharia encourages us to increase our ibadat in the month of Sha'ban. And the second point which we come to know from these ahadith is that Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to fast frequently in the month of Sha'ban. And the third thing we come to know is that all the amals are raised to Rabbul Alameen in the month of Sha'ban. The fourth point is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam disliked people to be ignorant, to be negligent of this month of Sha'ban. And the fifth thing which we come to know is that the list of all those people who are supposed to die that year is handed over to Malaika, to angels. So following these ahadith, following these virtues, and above all, there is a night which falls in the fifth Sha'ban, in the half of the month, which is called Laylatul Bara'ah. Though there are people who deny the importance, the significance of that night, there are ahadith, authentic ahadith, and there are aqwal of kibar al-muslimin, which clearly indicates its importance. I would like to quote a hadith. This hadith is narrated by Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala an, in which he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال يطلع الله إلى خلقه في ليلة النصف من شعبان فيغفر لجميع خلقه إلا لمشرك أو مشاحن أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. معاذ بن جبل رضي الله تعالى narrates that Nabi Kareem صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks over on his creation in the fourth night, in the 15th night of Sha'ban, and forgives all but two people: polytheist and the person who holds grudges against people. And this hadith is recorded by Hibban. Imam Ibn Hibban rahimahullah has recorded this hadith in his Sahih. And Imam Bayhaqi rahimahullah has recorded this hadith in his Shu'ubul Iman. And Imam Tabrani rahmatullah alayh has narrated this hadith in his book Al-Majmu'ul Kabir. And also, Imam Suyuti rahmatullah alayhi has mentioned this hadith in his book Durrul Manthur. And Imam Mundhari rahmatullah alayhi has recorded this hadith in his book At-Targhib wa At-Tarhib. And Shaykh Albani also has given a place to this hadith in his book Silsila Sahiha. There is another hadith of the same meaning. This hadith is narrated by Abu Tha'laba radiyallahu ta'ala, in which he said that قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان ليلة النصف من شعبان يطلع الله عز وجل إلى خلقه فيغفر للمؤمنين ويترك أهل الضغائن وأهل الحقد بحقدهم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. أبو ثعلبة رضي الله تعالى narrates That Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the 15th night of Shaban looks over at creation and He forgives all the believers except two people. And who are those two people? The person who holds grudges and the person who hates. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves them in their enmity. And finally, there is another hadith which is narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an, in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ اللَّهُ يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ لَيْلَةً نِصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِعِبَادِهِ إِلَّا لِثْنَيْنِ مُشَاحِنٍ وَقَاتِلِ نَفْسٍ أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the 15th night of Shaban looks over at His creation and He forgives all His ibad, all His slaves and servants except two kind of people. First, someone who holds a grudge against others and someone who has taken an innocent life. So these are hadiths almost with a similar meaning coming from different narrators, recorded by different books. This hadith also has been recorded by Imam Mundhir rahimahullah in his Targhib and Tarheeb, and Imam Ahmad rahimahullah has given a place to this hadith in his Musnad, and Hafiz al-Haythami in Majmu'ud Zawaid has recorded this hadith. So these are hadiths which talks about the importance, about the authenticity, about the significance of the 15th night of Sha'ban. Apart from it, we have quotations from Kibarul Ulama, Kibarul Muslimin, who have given importance to this night and they have acted upon it. And one of them is Sheikh Mansur Bahuti, Rahimahullah, who is a humbly Shaykh, and he has written in his book, which is very famous of humbly fiqh, Kashaful Qina. He says that as for the 15th night of Sha'ban, it is a night of virtue. Some of the Salaf prayed the whole night. Although establishing congregational prayers on this night is a bid'ah, is an innovation. And the reward of the ibadah on the 15th day of Shaban, night of Shaban, is the same as the reward of the ibadah on the night of Eid. And Imam Shafi rahimahullah, one of the greatest imams, he narrates, he writes in his book Al-Umm, which is very famous. He said, بلغنا أنه كان يقال إن الدعاء يستجاب في خمس ليال في ليلة الجمعة وليلة الأضحى وليلة الفطر وليلة وأول ليلة من رجب and وليلة النصف من شعبان. This quotation has been taken from his book Al-Umm. Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi says, of the narrations that have reached us, verily dua is accepted on five nights: the night of Jum'ah, the night of Eid al-Adha, the night of Eid al-Fitr, the first night of Rajab al-Murajjab, and the 15th night of Shaban al-Mu'adham. This is the quotation from the book of Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayh. And Shaykh Abu Ishaq Ibrahim al-Hambali rahimahullah says in his book Al-Mubdi, وَيُسْتَحَبُّ إِحْيَاءُ مَا بَيْنَ الْعِشَاءَيْنِ لِلْخَبَرِ قَالَ جَمَاعَةٌ وَلَيْلَةُ عَاشُورَ وَلَيْلَةُ أَوَّلِ رَجَبْ وَلَيْلَةُ نِصْفِ شَعْبَانِ. He said, it's desirable to revive the time with Salat and Ibadah between the two Ishas. What are the two Ishas? Between Maghrib and Isha. Because of the Ahadith, many scholars say similarly with the night of Ashura, the first night of Rajab, and the 15th night of Shaban. And also, Imam Shrambali Hanafi rahimahullah says in his book Nurul Idah that it's desirable to revive the last 10 nights of Ramadan, two nights of Eidain, that is Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah, and the 15th night of Shaban. And a question was asked by Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah regarding the significance of the 15th night of Shaban. And he said that, as for the 15th night of Shaban, there are many narrations and athar that are the quotes from the Sahaba kiram ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in regarding its virtue. And it has been reported of the Salaf, they prayed in this night. Therefore, praying alone on this night, having precedence, in Salaf is sufficient evidence, and something of this kind is surely something which cannot be denied, which cannot be rejected. And it was narrated by him in his Fatawa Ibn Taymiyyah, which is a very famous book of Fatawa. And at another occasion, so the same kind of question was asked by Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, and he answered, if one prays on this night alone or in a select company of people, as many group among the Salaf did, then it is good. But as for the congregating in the masjid upon the fixed prayer, like upon a salat with a 100 rakats and reciting Surah Ikhlas 1,000 times, then it is bid'ah. None of these scholars extolled this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And Shaykh Mubarak Puri rahmatullah alayh writes in his book Tuhfatul Ahwazi that all these ahadiths, all these narrations, all these quotations from kibar ulama are sufficient evidence to prove that the night of 15th Shaban is a night of virtue and significance. My dear brothers and sisters, the month of Shaban should not be neglected. The month of Shaban is a month of great virtue. It's a month in which the treasures of Rahmah are laid open, in which the blessings from heavens are sent down, in which the sins are expiated, in which the benediction are multiplied upon the best creation, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, instead of getting negligent, of being negligent of the importance of Shaban, all the believers are obligated to exert themselves in the preparation of Ramadan, using all days that are remaining, and repenting for all the sins which were committed, and getting clear out of the sins for the rest of their lives. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should appeal Him, we should beseech Him that He'd forgive us for all our sins which we did intentionally or unintentionally, till the corruption of our heart is cured, is gone, and the sickness of our inner being is cured. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to increase our ibadat in the month of Sha'ban, fasting, our recitation of Quran in this month, to get prepared for the month, for the blessed month with which to come, which is the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our ibadat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us able to welcome the month of Ramadan with the best soul, with the best spirit we have, and act upon all the umur, all the ahkam mentioned in Quran and in the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have 5 minutes for sunnah.